Hi guys, welcome back to Amy's Cooking. I hope you are all having a fantastic day. And if you're new to my channel, don't forget to hit the subscribe button. So today I will be sharing with you a savory recipe. This is bok khoa or Vietnamese beef stew. Bok khoa is a very popular beef soup that can be eaten with rice, noodles, or bread. Look at this piece of meat. By the look of it, you can tell this is totally authentic bok khoa. Yes, guys, we are not taking any shortcuts today. We will be making the real deal. This is the version that you will find at the Vietnamese restaurants. It contains all of the different herbs and spices. It is something that you are going to love so much. So what makes this beef soup so fantastic is that it contains different types of beef. You've got tendon, shanks, and briskets or roast that have been cooked to the point where it's so tender it just melts in your mouth. There are also carrots that add a crunch along with a flavorful broth with so many different herbs and spices. It is the perfect combination of flavors and texture. So the best way I like to eat the bok khoa is with banh mi or Vietnamese baguette. Even better, homemade ones. Yes, this is homemade. I have the link to the recipe in the description box below, along with all of the ingredients for the bok khoa recipe today. You definitely can make both of these amazing food in the comfort of your own home for your loved ones. So if you like what you see so far, let's get right to it. Okay guys, we are using three different types of beef today. What you see here is beef shank. Now first things first, you're gonna need a very sharp knife. What I'm doing here is I am removing or trimming off the silver skin off of this muscle. So silver skin is that layer that you see that covers the muscle. So the reason for removing it is because when you cook this shank, that layer is going to toughen up and it is not a good texture to bite into. So I know this is tedious, but if you have time, spend some time and remove as much as you possibly can. It should look like this once it's removed. Now this piece has a lot of it on here, so I, for the sake of time and the video, have only removed that much. But once that those layers have been removed, you can cut this into sizable pieces or cubes. So how big or how small will depend on you. Just make sure that when you're cutting it, it is tough. So you're gonna need a sharp knife and hold on to the meat really tight because it does get kind of slippery and I don't want you to cut yourself. So once all of the pieces have been cut up to the desired size, which as you can see here, this is about the size that I like the shank to be. You go ahead and toss them in a bowl and set it aside, and we're gonna cut the next type of meat. So here, this one, you can either use brisket or you can use roast. What you wanna do is make sure that you clean all of your beef with salt water and pat it dry before you cut them. Once you have cut those, put it together with the other one, and the last type that we're using is going to be tendons. You know, tendons are super tough, but it's actually one of the crucial ingredients of a Vietnamese beef stew. This is what's going to give you that little crunch when you bite into the different types of beef. This is the size that I like for it to be. It is very tough, so we will have to cook these halfway before we add it to the other meat. If you have an Instant Pot, go ahead and use it. If you don't have an Instant Pot, you have to boil this on the stove until it's about halfway cooked. To this, I am going to add a little bit of salt, about a teaspoon, and also add to it about a liter of water. So for the Instant Pot, if you do have, we are going to cook this for about 20 to 30 minutes. I'm gonna start with 20. If I need to increase it, I can do another 10 minutes. We are going to do quick release, and this is what it looks like. By this time, the tendons are still very tough, and that's kind of what you want it. You don't want it completely softened, because then when you cook it with the other meat, it's just going to be too soft. Rinse that and pat those dry, and then add them together with your roast or your brisket and also the shanks. And once they're all added, we are going to season it. So We want to divide this video into three parts. The first part is the marinade for the meat itself. And then the second part, I will walk you through how to do the broth. And then there's also the last part, which is going to be the final seasoning. So for the seasoning for the meat itself, I have added some sugar, salt, this is powder, garlic, and we have here some chopped lemongrass, which I just used the lemongrass stalk and I chopped it up really finely. We've got some ground black pepper as well as some vegetable seasoning. And of course, with every single Vietnamese savory dish, you can't go without the fish sauce. Now, once you have added all of those seasoning to the meat, we're gonna toss this and combine everything. The best thing to do with the meat at this point is to leave it overnight if you have time. If you don't have time, that's okay, but you still have to let it sit for about 30 minutes to an hour so that everything can soak into the meat before we start cooking it. While that sits and it gets marinated, we're gonna prepare the stuff for the broth. So here I have a couple of sticks of carrots, 1 to 2 large onions that are cut into slices, and also 2 stalks of lemongrass. I have also chopped up 1 large tomatoes, which I did not include the seeds. Also some tomato paste, chopped lemongrass, and also annatto powder, also some 5 spice powder. In addition to those, we'll also need some chopped garlic, chopped ginger, basil leaf, and a couple of different spices. So for the spices, we have cinnamon stick, cardamom, and a couple of pieces of star anise. So these are already included in the 5 spice powder, but I feel like these couple of extra pieces really makes a huge difference in this recipe. At this point, we can go ahead and prepare the pot for the broth. So to a large pot on medium-low heat, we're gonna add about 3 tablespoons of cooking oil. Now you want the oil to heat up just a little, so when you stick your chopstick tips to the pot, you will see some bubbles around it. At that point, add in the annatto powder. You don't want the heat to be too high because then that can cause this to burn and the color won't be as vibrant. At this point, go ahead and add in the chopped garlic, chopped ginger, and the chopped lemongrass. We will also be adding in the 5 spice powder and also the basil leaf. The chopped tomatoes is going to give it the extra sweetness as well as the very nice golden vibrant color. The tomato paste is going to thicken this up. We'll add in the lemongrass as well and about 1/2 cup of water to loosen everything. So you want to cook this for a couple minutes until things really kickstart the aroma. And once you feel that fantastic aroma, go ahead and toss in the marinated meat. So this part of the cooking process is a little tricky because you want to cook this meat and give it enough time so that it can absorb all of the different fragrance and aromas and herbs and seasonings that we've just added to the pot. So when you cook this on medium high heat, you will start to notice that the juice will come out, it's going to get more watery. So you want to continue to cook until all of that water dries up, and it will give time for the color to soak into the meat. So from this view here, it's really hard to see, but I will bring the meat closer to the camera so that you can truly see what it looks like and how beautiful the color looks. It needs to be like this, otherwise when you add in the water, it's going to take all of the color away and your meat's gonna look super pale. So you're going to add in 4 liters of water, and once you add in the 4 liters of water, you're going to add in the cinnamon stick as well as the cardamom and those few pieces of the star anise. You want to go ahead and let this Now everything boil and cook for about an hour to an hour and a half, depending on what kind of texture you like the meat to be, whether you like it a little bit on the chewer side or you like it more tender. But as soon as it gets to the texture that you like, go ahead and add in the carrots and the white onions. So the reason why I didn't add this in the very beginning is because, like I said, it takes at least an hour to an hour and a half for the meat to get softened. So if we had added in the beginning, all of that would be very mushy by this point. Look at the color of this. Does this not look fantastic? Or what? It smells so amazing. So once the carrots and the white onions are softened, go ahead and add in the rest of the seasoning. I just add in the coconut water, the sugar, the fish sauce, a little bit of salt, as well as some vegetable seasoning. I have all of these listed in the description box under the final seasoning section. So make sure you use it just enough to your liking. You don't have to add all of it. Depending on how long you cook this and how much water has evaporated, it can be a little different. So you do have to tweak those amount that I listed in the final seasoning section. The last thing that you saw I added there is a thickening agent, which is a combination of tapioca starch and some water. So the purpose of adding that is so that this isn't such a watery soup. It will thicken it up and it will give it a nice, more thickened type of soup, so that it's easier if you are dipping bread into this or eating this with noodles. Once you've added everything, you're gonna let it come to a boil and you're ready to serve. Look at this fantastic bacal. It is so authentic. The smell is so amazing. Top it up with a little bit of black pepper and you are ready to go. So guys, if you like this and you like bacal, you have to give this recipe a chance, okay? I promise it is so delicious. And so until next time, enjoy, and don't forget to hit the subscribe button.